Hello, my friends, and welcome back. Thank you very much for being with me again today. On the 16th of November, the Polish authorities stated that they will allow the Ukrainian experts, investigators, to come at missile site strike and when that missile fell in Poland and investigate alongside the Polish investigators and American investigators. That's what they said on the 16th. Now, on the 17th, which was yesterday, the Polish authorities said, no, this is a Polish matter and we will not allow the Ukrainians to participate in the investigation. We deny you access. You're not invited. I didn't hear anything about Americans being disinvited or not invited. And today I have an article here from the Ukrainian side stating that the Ukrainian investigators, experts, are at the site where the missile struck in Poland. Now, I don't know exactly what's going on here, but this change of yes, you can come, no, you can't come. Yes, we're actually there right now. I don't know, this comes from an Ukrainian media outlet, so I don't know, they wouldn't lie about that, right? So it comes from the European Pravda from November 18th. Ukrainian experts already working at the scene of the tragedy in Poland, Ukraine's Minister of Foreign Affairs states. So Minister of Foreign Affairs of Ukraine, Dmytro Kuleba, said that Ukrainian experts were already at the site where the missile had landed, killing two people. And I'm quoting, Ukrainian experts are already working at the site of the tragedy in Przewodów, caused by Russian missile terror against Ukraine, end quote. Dmytro Kuleba wrote on Twitter on Friday, today. Now, as you can pick out of this little statement is that he continues to say the tragedy caused by Russian missile terror against Ukraine. So he's not saying that it was a Russian missile that fell over there, but it says, like Stoltenberg of NATO and other weasels, it's still Russia is responsible for that, because the Russians attacked Ukraine and unjustified, right? So therefore, anything that you do in the meantime, if someone attacks me and I kill and I blow up three towns, it's still his fault because he attacked me. I'm not responsible that I accidentally or purposely kill other people, and I can use that as a justification. He attacked me, then I would go to my neighbor and take care of my neighbor, right? Is that how it goes? According to this logic, yes. So if there's a war, let's say United States is involved in a war, let's say with Spain, and in the meantime bombards Portugal, it's okay, right? Or Spain bombards Portugal in the meantime, it's okay, because let's say United States attacks Spain. Is that how it goes? Someone attacks me and I go and I shoot my neighbor, because he attacked me here. It's just a collateral thing. Well, if it's so easy, imagine that collateral are your parents or the loved ones, and see how you would see then how just that action is, or justification. I'm pretty sure if those people in, in Poland, if those people were yours, what would you say? Oh, yeah, it's because of the Russians. Whose missile fell on that? That's what killed those people. Anyway, it's just that these guys take this route of weaselness and continue saying the Russian missile terror and so on. Things are not so clear-cut in certain situations. You can point fingers at the Russians. Yes, they invaded our territory. Well, when you ask the Russians, they say, no, it's our territory, and we just intervene to save lives. So what are you going to say about that? You were not killing those people over there? Oh, we were killing them because why? They want to separate away from us? Why did they want to separate away from us? Oh, I don't know, because they're crazy, they're Russians. No, it's because of the 2014, remember? So if you go back, and then what happened in 2014? Who helped that happen? And why? Oh, you have to go back to NATO. Oh, you have to go back to this. So it's not that easy, Kuleba. But Kuleba, you know, he's just, you know, he knows what he's doing. He also thanked the Polish side for granting access. Okay, we will continue our cooperation in an open and constructive manner, as closest friends do, Kuleba said. Closest friends that are ready to take your western part of your country, which belongs to them and was given to you. So it was given. You didn't take it. It was given to you. Why you didn't take it? You didn't have the power to take it. That's the only thing. Somehow, I don't want to be bad, but I will be bad. You have, like, in a neighborhood, you have a group of children, and a child, the weakest one, is given ice cream from other children. And he's given this, he's given that, he's given, and say, what is going on? I mean, this kid doesn't have, you know, personality, doesn't have strength, doesn't have intelligence. I mean, basically, and he gets everything from everybody around. So you take from Hungarian kid, you get the ice cream. You take from the Romanian kid, I don't know, the football ball. You take from the, I don't know, the Russian kid, you're given all these things. You're given. You didn't take them because Ukraine did not take anything. It was given by others. And who are the other others? And that's the weakest kid, because the weakest kid was not able to take anything. Was given. And was not even a country, to put it this way. It was always added to by other ones. And you think, how is it possible? Because in the world we live in, if you're strong, then you take it. So that's an anomaly here. Earlier, the head of the International Policy Bureau in the Chancellery of the President of Poland, Jacob, announced that Ukrainian experts would be allowed to the site where the missile had landed in the village. Before that, the investigation had been conducted by a joint Polish-American team. Why American? Why American? Why not French? Why not Chinese? And why not Russian? Why American? What does America have to do with this? I mean, you make sense of that. I mean, we know why. Polish President Andrzej Duda said on November 16, the explosion in eastern Poland was where an explosions in eastern Poland were an accident, and Warsaw does not consider the incident with a missile an attack on the country, unless it's Russian. If it's Russian, if it's Russian, that's an attack, it's bad. If it's Ukrainian, it's okay. You know, so if the bullet comes from this guy and kills your kid, is okay. But the bullet coming from the other guy and kills your kid is not okay anymore. Now you tell me how this would work in real life. Duda was probably fired by the Ukraine air. He said that the missile that fell, it did not fall. It was just anyway. Was probably fired by Ukrainian air defense forces. He also stated that he understood the statements of his Ukrainian counterpart, Zelensky, who said Ukraine was not involved in a missile accident in the village of blah, blah, blah on Tuesday, as a result of which two people died. Well, however you take it, you can look at the circumstances. You have to look at the circumstances. That's for sure. That's for sure. But also you have to look that these guys are trying to create a narrative now. That's why it's just the Americans over there and the Poles. There's nobody else involved, nobody else allowed. Now they say, oh, we allowed Ukrainians. Why? Because Ukrainians were big mouth and they say, well, it was this, it was that, it was this, it was not us, and so on. And they were told, shut the fuck up. We're going to come with a statement here, not you. You just stay over there and do your thing, what you're supposed to, with the Russians, okay? You make sure your people are... and whatever, we're going to give you everything you need for you to die, but the big things, let us handle them. You just pull the trigger and send these things, and that's it. And you fight heroically. I'm not denying that, both sides, because both sides are in a war. So you save your skin and whatever, save your country, and fight for whatever you think is right. So let us deal with that. But now I think that they allow the Ukrainians, I think, like this. You come here, politically it looks like you're involved, but you shut the fuck up. You just pretend you're here, but we're gonna say what the, what happened. We're gonna find, well, we're gonna put you everything on all this. Yes, we investigated, we were three countries. We're gonna put you over there. But the ultimate decision is gonna be by United States of America, and Ukraine will shut the fuck up. Because if it doesn't, the clowns must go. We're gonna bring other clowns over there to conduct whatever we want to conduct. That's how I think it is. Maybe it's not as accurate as I would say, but if you think that Ukraine has, and why Ukraine would have so much power, why would you invite Ukraine there? And you say, well, Emil, it's a party involved in this, right? There are missiles, it's an investigation. Okay, then why didn't you invite Russia too? Because they're the bad dudes. Well, it doesn't work that way, unless you're a pig. And if you're a pig, you look at it this way. And then I will not even pay attention to your conclusion. I will just regard it, which I will, because they invited Russia? No, they invited international investigators or observers? No. I don't think it has authority or relevance. Look at the pipelines, like Nord Stream 1, Nord Stream 2. They didn't invite Russia. Why? Russia is like, you have your car was blown up, and you're not allowed to go over there. But by the way, are allowed other people? Or it's just us because it was in the, no, it's my car. It's my child, it's my, what do you mean I can't even observe? No, it's us. But over here, no, you're okay. You're allowed to come, Ukraine, in the same kind of circumstance. So these kind of things do not have authority if they're not just. And I don't think they're just. They're not transparent, as these people say here, you know. And when you conduct an investigation in this case, it's not, oh my God, it's confidential information. What is confidential? It's confidential what you're going to find. You don't want us to see what you're going to find and what you're going to tell us. Because it's going to be, this is what you find and this is what you're going to tell us. They're not going to be overlapping. But obviously, I don't know what happened. I know that some people died hit by a rocket or two. Was that Russian? Was that Ukrainian? I don't know. It's just this guy said, no, it was not Russian. It was Ukrainian. Now, it was it because those guys launched it and tried to intercept Russian missiles? Possible. Was it shot to create a problem between NATO and Russia? Possible. Was it an accident? Possible. Was it purposely done? Possible. All these things are on the table. But the way you conduct it shows me that you are conducting like this. I'm gonna tell you immediately what I found. No, that's not how you conduct an investigation if you're fair, honest, and impartial. Well, it's good that they are over there, the Ukrainians are over there, and the Russians are not. Thank you very much for being with me again today. Stay strong, stay smart, look for the truth, and be just.